everyone. Welcome to our channel, Biology for All. In this video, I'm going to talk about topic 3.3, skill 1, drawing diagrams to show the stages of meiosis. Meiosis is a division that results in formation of 4 haploid cells. Meiosis has 2 divisions, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2, that is 2 nuclear divisions, and each undergoes prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Let's begin by drawing the prophase stage. So here I have drawn the cell with the nuclear membrane as a dotted line and the blue representing the paternal and the red representing the maternal chromosomes. The centrioles have moved towards the poles with spindle microtubules arising from it. Nuclear envelope is shown in dotted lines as it is disintegrating, and the homologous pairs are seen here as they pair up in a process called synapsis. Next is metaphase. In metaphase, the nuclear membrane has completely disintegrated and the spindle microtubules move ahead to attach to the centromere of the chromosomes. The chromosomes align on the equatorial plate in their pairs, that is, the homologous pairs or the bivalents are arranged on the equatorial plate. So in anaphase 1, the homologous pairs that had arranged themselves along the equatorial plate now start moving away from each other towards the poles. So here the spindle microtubules, they contract, leading to the centromere of the chromosome being pulled towards the opposite poles. This results in separation of the homologous pairs. Here you can also see the result of crossing over in the form of the exchanged genetic material in the non-sister chromatids. So here the homologous pairs separate and move to opposite poles. Anaphase 1 is followed by telophase 1, which is the last stage of meiosis 1. The homologous pair that had separated during anaphase now moves towards the poles. A nuclear envelope starts to form here, and we can see that the chromosome number has now reduced in the nucleus. So from the parental cell, which had 4 chromosomes, now we have only 2 chromosomes. After meiosis 1, meiosis 2 begins. Now meiosis 2 does not have a interphase stage unlike other divisions, and it directly follows with the prophase stage. So here we can see that the nuclear membrane is again starting to disappear and the chromosomes have condensed and are clearly visible here. The centrioles with the spindle microtubules are formed. Prophase 2 is followed by metaphase 2. In metaphase 2, the chromosomes now align themselves on the equatorial plate. The nuclear membrane has completely disappeared, and on both the cells that performed in meiosis 1, both the cells show the presence of the chromosomes at the center or the equatorial plate. The spindle microtubules attach to the centromere of the chromosomes on both the sides. Next, it is followed by anaphase stage. Now, in anaphase, again here, the spindle microtubules start to contract for both the cells. This contraction results in pulling of the centromere such that the sister chromatids of each chromosome are now separated. So the sister chromatids, when they are separated, they start moving towards the poles of each of the cell. Anaphase 2 is followed by telophase 2. Now the chromatids which had separated during anaphase 2 have now reached the poles and the nuclear envelope starts developing. So here the cells that are formed are now completely haploid cells.